Hey guys, how are you? It's good to see you. It is Sunday about midday, and I didn't shoot any video at all yesterday. It was raining and 45 degrees, and my old body just don't like rain and 45 degrees, so we didn't come outside and do anything. We did a few things indoors. Nothing video worthy, but it looks to be a nicer day today. It is about 65 degrees now, and it's on a Sunday at almost noon, I think. So anyway, it doesn't matter. I come outside to check on all the stuff that we've got going on out here. So I thought I'd bring you along. We're going to look at some different stuff. We'll look at the experiments that we did with the tomatoes. We overwintered them, like I told you a couple days ago. Overwintered them. We overwintered bell pepper plant. So, and we've got plants started in the greenhouse, so we need to check on them, see how everything's doing. Didn't get out here yesterday. Need to today. We'll give you a little quick look at the change in our beds in the last 48 hours or so. Our red Russian kale's looking real good. Everything, considering we got a little bit of a late start, everything's looking pretty darn good. Windy, so I'm gonna keep it short. Hang on, I'm gonna flip the screen, all right? So here is the bed with the red Russian kale in it. I think it's looking pretty good. What do you guys think? And I think the squash and the kale are going to be able to cohabitate. I hope. Here we have collards and some lettuce that looks like they're starting to take off. They should probably be doing better, but that's my fault, not theirs. Here is Swiss chard. And I got to tell you, I think this cold snap, it was cold for an old man, this little bit of a chill we got, looks like it has been darn good for the raised beds. But mostly I have cold crops out here. We've got there's that stray garlic bulb we found. It looks to be doing well. And so I think the cold snap's done a lot of good. The rain obviously did. There's my butterfly bush. It's going to be beautiful, I think. Let's check the others. We're going to dig that out and get some topsoil in it, and then compost layer on top, and then we're going to plant that bed too, just real shortly. And right there, what I done is kind of a joke. Seems to be doing okay. The other seemingly dead butterfly bush seems to have new life. Okay. I got a mold problem here, as you can see. The leaf lettuce looks like it's doing real well, but I can't remember what these are, but they don't look like they're doing so well. And the garlic hasn't come up, but you can see the gooseberry bush is doing well, and so are the horseradish roots. And those three pots right there are those walnuts we found in an earlier video. And I may still salvage a couple more and get them planted. But those are all walnuts that we put in a bucket just in case it was a harsh winter. And they sprouted. So I hope trees grow. And if trees grow, we're going to plant them. I'm a little bit excited about it. Here's the greenhouse. I'm going to get off of here for a second, get everything opened up, and then I'll bring you back. I haven't seen it yet either, so you and I are both going to see it together for the first time. But all the stuff that we put in here a couple days ago, let's check on it. So back in a minute. Okay, folks, she's opened up. You can feel the heat coming out of it. Let's start right here. Those are squash plants, couple of cucumber plants, three cucumber plants. So anyway, some squash and cucumber plants. A few of the squash look like they didn't or are not going to make it. But hey, whatever makes it, makes it. Those are all volunteers. And it's really kind of early for them anyway, but we'll see. Whatever makes it, makes it. Here's a tomato plant that looked almost dead when I planted it, but it actually looks a little better today, which ain't saying much. Here are bush bean and cucumber plants. They look like being put in here was a good thing for them. The tomato plants, looking a little peaked, looking a little weary, looking a little maybe half dead on a couple of them. But they're still alive. That one, it's questionable at best. But we're going to water them tonight, or here in just a little bit. And anyway, we're going to check it out. We're going to give them a chance to live. If they don't live, we'll compost them, and we'll reuse the mix that they're planted in. So that's it. Didn't get a ton of rain, but that'll give you an idea how much rain we did get. We needed it. It was just 45 degrees. Didn't do it for me. Oh, I want to show you over here too. Let me try not to jerk the camera around and walk too fast. That is, well, crap, I already forgot. It was given to us last fall, comfrey. It was given to us last fall. It looked pretty rough. We brought it home, threw it in the ground, and it looks to be doing great right now. Here is what not knowing what you're doing when you plant mint will do for you. We've got a lot of it. We'll use it. We'll cut it down and we'll make tea out of it. We'll make bedding for the nesting boxes for the chickens. But it will take over your yard and your life. So we'll thin it out some. Rose bushes are looking fantastic. There's a tiger lily that is doing phenomenal. We're really impressed with it. And one, here's a something I just learned. The thing about using wood chips, I never thought about the fact that there would be tree seeds in the chips. So we have several small trees coming up. Not sure what they are. I just noticed them yesterday. We'll look and see what they are. If they're worthy, we'll dig them up and transplant them and see how that goes. If they're not worthy, we'll pull them up and they'll be compost and mulch. Here is the bell pepper plant. I was worried that it dropped a little too cold, but it looks fine. And we're behind on planting a few things. So, just wanted to show you what's going on. If we get into anything else I think you might be interested in, I'll turn the camera back on. If not, please like, share, and subscribe. Godspeed, folks. Hey guys, I wanted to jump back in here for just a minute. And show you what I got going on. I got a thought in my head and the energy to do it, and everything came together, so we're starting the next project. Hang on and I'll show you what I'm talking about. All right, I showed you this raised bed earlier. It was where our world-class compost is. So we're going to change this into a raised bed, but we've got a mold problem. And I realize that wire has a bigger gap than I would like. I'd like 1 by 1, 1 inch by 1 inch. But this was given to us last summer by a lady that was doing some work around her place. So we're going to use it. We're going to put this in the bottom. And then we're going to take out the rest of that compost. Oh, by the way, there's where the rest of it went. It went into what will be the chicken's dust bath, the little kitty swimming pool. And then we put some compost around the butterfly bush that we did not think was going to make it. But anyway, we're going to take that topsoil that is growing the most beautiful horseweed you've ever seen. And we will bring it down here and we will put this on top of the wire, and then we will take this compost and put it back on top of that, and we'll plant right smack into it. So tell me what you think. Wire waste of my time, waste of resources, or will this at least deter them in this one bed? Please leave a comment in the section below. And thanks for watching, guys. Godspeed. All right, guys, here's what I came up with. We've got moles very badly, and I want to start making our beds where they're at least more mold proof than they are. This wire was given to us, and those holes or those little rectangles are too big. A mole will come right through them. I've got chicken wire that we also picked up as a freebie, just pieces. And those holes alone are also too big. Mole get right through them. But if you lace the chicken wire over the whatever you call the other wire, it makes it a much smaller holes for the moles to get through. And it's stuff that I've got and we don't have any money invested in. So other than spend a little time on it, it shouldn't be a bad deal. It ought to work. I mean, it ought to work, and it ought to work cheaply. So that's what we're doing. I'll show you the finished product. Oh, probably won't be today, but I'll show you soon. So with that, we are going to close. Today is my eldest daughter's birthday, my first true love. And we're going to wrap up a little early today, and we're going to meet her and my granddaughter, who just turned 18 a few days ago. We're going to meet them for dinner and buy their dinner. So if Whitney and Mackenzie, if you're watching, I love you very much. Happy birthday to both of you. And to all the rest of you, Godspeed. Please like, share, and subscribe. And you can find us on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook as well. And y'all have a great day.